California, USA, 2017. A software developer named Ibrahim Diallo was awakened by a phone call. It was his recruiter. He said to himself, "Why is she calling me so early?" and allowed it to go to voicemail. He got out of bed and prepared for work. On his way to work, he listened to a voicemail which said, "Oh my God, are you okay?" As concerned as she sounded, he wasn't bothered. He knew that he was okay, and furthermore, he wasn't the only Ibrahim Diallo who worked at the company, so he brushed it off and said she must have dialed the wrong Ibrahim. Upon his arrival at work, he noticed something was wrong. He scanned his keycard like he did every morning, but this time he couldn't get through the turnstile. The security guard began laughing and a few seconds later, pressed a button underneath his desk to allow Ibrahim to go through. Ibrahim was now beginning to get worried. Maybe ignoring the earlier call wasn't such a good idea, he thought. He proceeded to call his recruiter. She tells him that she got an email about him earlier that morning, but it must have been a mistake. She then asked if he was allowed in the building, to which he responded, "Yes, they let me in the building. What's happening?" She told him she thinks there is confusion and she's gonna speak to a manager then call him right back. At that point, Ibrahim was trying to convince himself that this was all a well-coordinated prank. After all, he was friends with the security guard and so began wondering if he had disabled the turnstile just before he scanned his keycard. To find out what was going on, Ibrahim went to his manager to ask her if everything was okay. To his surprise, his manager had no idea what was going on. He told her about the call from his recruiter and that he was waiting for her to call back. Ibrahim went to his desk and while he worked, constantly looked at his phone in anticipation of that phone call, but that call would never come. It was now the end of his shift and here he was on his way home, even more confused than when he came in that morning. The next day, he drove to work and as customary, brought his car into the company's parking lot. Immediately, he realized that something was wrong. Scanning his card wasn't granting him access to the compound. To make matters worse, he was holding up a line of cars and preventing dozens of employees from getting to work on time. Impatient drivers started honking their horns at him. Ibrahim silently panicked. Just when it seemed like the situation was escalating, a security guard noticed what was going on and came to the rescue of a visibly relieved Ibrahim. Confused and embarrassed, Ibrahim drove up to the 8th floor where he worked. Just like the previous day, his keycard failed and the security guard had to let him through. Still trying to remain optimistic, Ibrahim convinced himself that the problem was a faulty keycard and it will all be fixed once he gets a new one. Immediately, he went to see his manager. She promised to get him a new one right away, with the only inconvenience being he would have to get a temporary one printed every morning until his new keycard arrived. So, problem solved, right? Wrong. Ibrahim went to his desk to get some work done on his computer when he noticed he had been logged out of his developer account. He tried multiple times to log in, but it failed every single time. Believing it was a system error, he asked a coworker if the system was down. To his surprise, it wasn't. He was the only one who couldn't log in. Ibrahim then asked his coworker to look for his ticket number. What his coworker saw left him scratching his head. Ibrahim's name was grayed out, and next to his name had the word inactive. This was something his manager could fix, but there was one small problem. It was already lunchtime. He went out to buy some food and on his way back decided to take the stairs, something he did regularly to counter sitting down all day. With all that has been going on, Ibrahim forgot that he needed to scan his keycard to enter the building. He was now stuck on the stairs. After waiting for about 10 minutes, the door finally opened when a coworker who took the stairs entered the building. Ibrahim snuck in behind him like a common thief. Suddenly, his phone rang. It was his recruiter calling back a full day and a half later. She was panicking. She apologized, then asked him if everything was okay. Before he could even say anything, she told him she received an email saying he was terminated. He ran to his manager's office seeking clarification, but his manager had received no such email. She had no idea why his profile was disabled, and to make things worse, the system wasn't allowing her to re-enable it. Visibly concerned, Ibrahim went back to his desk and saw a big error message on his computer screen asking him to reboot. He didn't comply because he had many windows open and he knew if he restarted his computer, he would not only lose his work, he would be locked out of the computer altogether. He documented his work for the rest of the day, then went home. The next day, Ibrahim took an Uber to work to avoid another embarrassing parking situation. When he got to work, the inevitable happened. He was embarrassed yet again. He couldn't get a temporary badge printed because his name appeared in red and flagged in the system. His manager had to personally come downstairs to escort him into the building. Before he could breathe a sigh of relief, he got a text message from his recruiter. In that message, she told him she had just received word that his badge had been used while he had been terminated, so he should not report to work today. Of course, he was already at work, so it was too late. A frustrated Ibrahim went straight to the director and asked her, "Am I fired or not?" She laughed while dialing the number for support. With her voice oozing with authority, she ordered them to immediately restore everything back to normal before hanging up. She assured Ibrahim that everything would be fine, and this issue would be resolved by the end of the day. But before he could even leave her office, she received an email. He couldn't help but notice the concerned look on her face while she read the email. It was horrific news. Ibrahim's case was closed, with the following message attached: IT contractor terminated. Before he could even process what had just happened, there was an emergency. There was a big problem with the multi-million dollar tool he had been working on. Hundreds of thousands of records were missing, and the web interface was unresponsive. Ibrahim rushed to his desk, only to see that his Windows machine had been automatically restarted and his account had been disabled. The tools he normally used for development were no longer accessible. With some quick thinking, he used another machine to hack his way into the server, where he was able to reactivate all the services and reprocess the data. Before he left the building, he went to see the director, who was still on the phone with support, trying to resolve this mess. She gave him the okay to return to work the following day. The next day, he had been locked out of every single system except his Linux machine. Even the service he used to log his work hours had been deactivated. Ibrahim spent the entire morning documenting his work, but things would take a turn for the worse after lunch. Two security guards whom he knew very well walked up to him and with a heavy heart told him they were here to escort him. They had received a threatening email with instructions to escort Ibrahim out of the building. The director was livid. Ibrahim was fired and there was nothing she or his manager could do about it. They stood powerless as he packed up his things and left the building. With all of this unfolding, there were two very important questions which were left unanswered. 1. Who was the one sending these emails? And 2. Why was Ibrahim fired in the first place? It would take him 3 weeks to find out. Over the next few weeks while at home, Ibrahim noticed something very unusual. He was being copied on emails about his case and realized that some of them were system emails. He described them as being soulless and written in red as they gave orders that dictated his fate. Some of these orders were: revoke access here, disable this, disable that, escort out of premises, etc. What was even more baffling and hurtful for Ibrahim was the fact that for the 8 months he worked there, he was constantly praised for his exceptional performance, yet he was at home without a job. After 3 frustrating weeks of being home, he finally got a call from his recruiter telling him the problem had been resolved and that he can come back to work. Ibrahim was anxious to get an explanation, but was also upset that he had just lost 3 weeks of wages for reasons beyond his control. Once he got to the workplace, his questions were answered. The person who was responsible for firing him wasn't a person at all. It was a computer. Yes, a computer was responsible for putting Ibrahim through hell and back before eventually firing him. But why? Why did the computer fire him? To answer this question, we need to go back 8 months to when Ibrahim first joined the company. You see, just before he was hired, that company was acquired by a much larger company, and so he came in during the transition. His manager at the time was from the previous administration. One morning, Ibrahim came to work and realized his manager's desk had been wiped clean. He had essentially been laid off and made to work from home as a contractor for the duration of the transitional period. As a full-time employee, he wasn't pleased with that decision and so chose not to work much. One of the things he did not do was renew Ibrahim's contract in the new system. Once his contract in the old system had expired, it set off a chain reaction. The order for his termination was put in based on the old contract and the computer system took over. When the order for disabling his keycard was sent, there was no way to re-enable it. An email was sent to security showing them a list of recently dismissed employees, which explains why his keycard didn't get him through the turnstile. By trying to enter the building with the disabled keycard, it triggered even more orders, which were sent out over the course of a few days, ending with his eventual firing. To add insult to injury, Ibrahim could only get his job back as a new employee, which meant he had to fill out an application and wait for his new keycard to be delivered to him via FedEx. While this ordeal did not ruin Ibrahim's life, it affected his relationship with his co-workers. Although Ibrahim's firing wasn't his fault, his co-workers looked at him differently and became distant. Shortly after, he made the decision to leave the job. He knew he was leaving behind a great opportunity to work for a big company, but the working environment had become uncomfortable for him. Ibrahim has since found a new job, and for his sake, I hope he never has to experience something like that again. Ibrahim Diallo's situation serves to remind all of us about the dangers of relying too heavily on artificial intelligence. There should be a way for a human to intervene in situations like this. Artificial intelligence is being used more and more in the workplace to not only carry out terminations, but it is also an integral part of the hiring process. The companies who use it say it eliminates bias in the interviewing phase, but there are concerns that the machines themselves may make biased decisions as they rely on all the data they have collected in the past. So if the data shows that a certain gender, people with a particular ethnic group, or those who attended a specific university have a high productivity rate, these people may stand a better chance of being hired when their applications are processed by a machine. What are your thoughts on artificial intelligence being used to hire and fire employees? And what would you have done if you were in Ibrahim's situation? Let me know in the comment section. If you enjoyed this video, please leave me a like and subscribe to my channel for more tech-related videos. As always, thanks so much for watching. I'll see you in the next one. Peace.